Okay, welcome back. We're missing a whole team. So we say MIA, missing in action. And missing in action can be shot by your friend army, right? Yes, missing in action. 逃走兵は銃殺刑ですからね。 Okay. So, in the morning, we talked about a lot about principles and philosophies and way of thinking. And I hope that kind of gave you an impression of system thinking is not something really, really difficult. But it's easy to understand, but difficult to practice. Do you understand that? Yes. It's easy to understand, but it's difficult to practice. So if I say, okay, let's do this in a systems approach way, then you will probably freeze because, okay, what is whole? What is part? It's very difficult to, it's very sensitive to define that. So from now on, I'm going to show you, I'm going to present you with some tool set or some techniques to do systems approach. And they are, again, like we did on Monday, these are not complete set of the tools. These are just some tools that is suitable for systems approach. And I have chosen these because this is more useful than other tools in design process. And especially for creative design process or innovative thinking design process. So that's why I've chosen these four. Okay. Again, before we get in, I'm going to do value graph first. That's a purpose and then the alternative viewpoint. And then our parts or elements or subsystem or whatever you call it will be higher purposes and then alternative ideas. You'll see these as elements. And then you'll see interrelation with them. And then causal loop diagram, CVCA, and function physics architecture. So let's start. Let's start from value graph. Like I said, value graph, and we're going to just talk about the upper half, but it is about the purpose and then the alternative viewpoints. And higher purposes and alternative ideas, you will see a lot of this in the diagram, but what we're doing is a purpose and alternative viewpoint. So this is what it actually looks like, and I have put a lot of reference. You have that paper, right? Okay, yeah. You have the handouts. Do you? Oh, it's coming. It's coming. Yeah. Right. So, thank you. This is, hey, there you are. Good. What's that? Yeah, right. Hey, guys, we need to shoot you guys because you were missing in action. You're considered to be a 逃走兵, so you'll be shot by us. That's what Akari said, so. Blame on her, okay? Okay, let's resume. So this is what value graph looks like, and then I have put a citation here. This methodology or tool is actually developed or invented by Professor Kosuke Ishii. He actually sadly passed away in 2009. He was a professor of Stanford University Mechanical Engineering. And he used to teach Mechanical Engineering 317, Design for Manufacturing, Design for Manufacturing, DFM, that's what it used to call. You know ME 310, that's a design thinking class. And it's there is ME 3112, 312, there is ME 317 and 15, and then this is like one of their series. And ME 317 used to be more of a manufacturing type techniques and methodologies, but Professor Ishii, he used to teach in D school as well. So he used to come to KO, SDM, and then we had, he is one of the fathers of design project class that we teach here now. And so this methodology was invented by him, and a little bit about Professor Ishii, he used to work for Toshiba, yes, Toshiba, and he went to Stanford, he became a professor, and he was a really interesting and fun guy to chat with, and then he was a fantastic professor. However, he passed away all of a sudden in 2009, soon after he finished developing the first generation of this design project class, we still keep on going in KOSDM. So, right, so this is what he left us several years ago, and we are still following that. So value graph, this is a description. A value graph is from a technique called value engineering, and then it allows designers, design teams to systematically review their objectives and propose design at various stages of product development. This is how they claim what this is. And basically, this technique is developed based on functional structural analysis, structure analysis from value engineering, and it associates values of the concept, and then the functions that's required for the concept, and then the concept itself. And it visualizes the interrelationship. So that's what it is. And originally used for product and service design. So that's what this is. I don't care if you remember this thing or not. It just care. I care what you do it. So I'll just quickly go over what this is. So you need to think, you want to think beyond your first idea. Okay, here's my small talk about value. This is value graph. So the first design can haunt you. Who understand this meaning? The first idea can haunt you. So when you are thinking about something, and when you're trying to design something, you'll get first idea anyways, right? Then can you throw away your first idea? Maybe after like a week or two thinking about your first idea becomes your first baby, right? Can you throw away your first baby? No, it's very difficult. It becomes very, very adorable. You have an attachment to your first idea. But your first idea is not always the best idea. Sometimes it is. As a matter of fact, it is sometimes, but it's not always like that. So you need to eliminate or discard your first idea, but it's difficult. How can we do it easily or effectively? It is to consider the higher level purpose or meta thinking, okay, and set your mindset free for better design options. So that's what we're doing. That's what we're doing. So consider the higher level purpose is that, okay, for example, let's see, what can I take as an example? Let's see, okay, let's say I have invented this board, okay? This board helps me to give lectures. This board, I invented this. My first idea was to write on the board with the pen. That's erasable. I thought this is the great idea. This is my first idea, and I have invented and I have modified the pen size and then the color and then the weight, and it seems working great. However, sometimes I need to seek for a better option. Okay? So but I really like this idea of my pen, using pen to give lectures. But I need to remind myself the higher level purpose. So I was not intended to develop the pen and board, right? My intention was to present or to do the lecture better, right? To give a better lecture. That was my purpose. So these were just tools to do so. So I wanted to give a better lecture. I start concentrate on that. So my lecture style is a lot of talking and discussing and changing things around. So maybe this is better option. Not writing on the board directly, but instead, maybe I should have this to give a better lecture, because this way I can write, and then I can modify it, and I can maybe change it. Do like this. This is better lecture for me. So now I'm not focusing on what I have invented or what I have came up in the first place, but I'm more thinking towards my purpose. What did I really want it to do? Okay? Like why and what domain, not how domain. Do you understand? So this was my how. I want to give a good lecture because I want to, you know, get a good class, good class climate, and then I want you to learn better, right? And I want you to become a global entrepreneur or entrepreneur in global context. So that's my intention, why, right? And then what is a give a lecture, give a good lecture. And then how was a board and a pen? So I should not stay myself in a how domain, but I should be thinking about, I need to give a good lecture. Well, what is my good lecture? My good lecture is not just writing on a board, plain writing or drawing. It's actually moving. It's more dynamic. So I should probably do this dynamic hows instead of just writing on the board. Okay? So that's meta thinking. I don't stick to how option or your first option, and then identify different level of purposes to help generate alternative creative design options. I'll show you how. This is actually how Professor Ishii invented this methodology back in 1987. Yes, I know there are so many people who were not born in 1987, right? I guess, but anyways. So this is interesting. He had a discussion with Apple computer engineers back in 1987 when he was in Stanford, and then he created this diagram. Okay, so this is not value graph. This is a conceptual model of the value graph. So, okay, let's pretend that we have an Apple engineer here. I'm a Professor Ishii, okay? And Apple engineer came to me and said, hey, Professor Ishii, I am looking at cooling fan. We're working on a cooling fan, better cooling fan for our product. What do you think we should do? And I'm Professor Ishii. Okay, cooling fan, that's not bad. But however, let's think about the higher level purposes. What is your cooling fan doing for? What is the ultimate purpose or higher level purpose of your cooling fan? You don't want cooling fan, but what do you really want? And the engineer will say, well, I don't necessarily have I don't care about the cooling fan, but I do care about generating airflow. I do care about generating airflow. Okay, yeah, all right. Then cooling fan is one option. But why don't induce convection? Convection is, why don't you give more airflow, okay? Airflow, not fan, but, the natural airflow. So to have a more natural airflow, why don't you have arranged PCB vertically? So it's a kibang. It's an electronic board, vertical, so that you have more air going up and down. Or why don't you make more holes instead of having fan? Why don't you make, can't you make more holes on the body of the computer? That's what I would ask. And engineer would say, that's an alternative. Those are options that I can take. And I will go further. Okay, I'm Professor Ishii. I will ask more. So you said you want to generate airflow, but you have a higher purpose, don't you? What is your higher purpose of generating flow? What do you really want? And engineer would answer, I want to remove heat. I want to remove the heat inside. That's what I want. I don't care about generating airflow or not. As long as I can remove heat, that's fine. Okay, so generating airflow and then getting rid of heat is one idea, but what about water-cooled the device? How about that? Could it be an option? And the engineer would say, yeah, that could be an option. So that's an alternative for generating airflow. And I will go further. So removing heat is not your goal, right? What is your higher purpose? Then engineer will think and say, I want to maintain the temperature inside. I don't care if I removed heat or not, but I do care. I want to maintain the temperature. So the removing heat is one option, but reducing wattage of device. So if you have a smaller wattage device inside, you get less heat produced, so you can maintain temperature, right? Or you can just ship the device to Antarctica. Do you know where that is? 南極? So this is a joke from Ishii Sensei, who died already, written in the book, why don't you ship it to the North Pole or South Pole? Then you don't have to care about the temperature. This is a joke in the book. It's difficult, but. So maintain temperature, you have three options, okay? And we can go further. So maintaining temperature is, yes, important, but what is your higher purpose? Then engineer would answer, enhance reliability of the product and prolong the life. So you want more, you want your product to last longer. So maintaining temperature could be one option, but the other option would be use better computer chips so that it would long no matter the heat, no matter the temperature, no matter what. So as you see here, these are higher level goals, right? These are higher level purposes in a ladder, it's a layers. And then these are options. These are alternative options. You never thought about, when you are so stick to the cooling fan idea, you don't really think about reducing wattage of device, right? You don't really think about use better chips when you are so into cooling fan. Imagine yourself being a cooling fan engineer. You will be trying to make it like less noisy, right? Maybe small and look cool and cheap. You'll be spending hours and hours of time to make a better cooling fan. But never use better chips idea. So what this is suggesting is that you want to figure out the higher purposes and you may seek for other options. Some option may not be available for you because of the resource limitation, the restrictions, but you want to seek the other options. That's the whole point of this. So that's where he created a structure called value graph. Let me do this in Japanese because I know it's a little bit conceptual and it's kind of hard to understand and it requires some vocabulary. So I'll do it in Japanese first and I'll show it in English. So, このタイミングが難しいのよ。このどこから日本語になるんだっけかなみたいな。はい。で、魚群探知機でいきましょう。これ本当に日本無線さんと一緒に、今日日本無線のおじさん来てないですけど、時々来る真っ黒おじさんがいるんですけど、魚群探知機のうちの学生でした。日本無線と一緒に作った魚群探知機。魚群探知機分かりますかね、大体船に乗ってるやつ。魚群探知機のバリューグラフの上半分っていうのを作ってみましょうということですね。で、上位の目的と代替案を作っていくっていうのがバリューグラフの作り方。こんな感じです。魚群探知機ってそもそも何の目的であるんだっけかと。魚の群れを可視化する目的でありますと。ですよね。じゃあ、魚の群れを可視化する代替案は何でしょう。魚の群れを可視化する代替案は、潮目などから頭の中にイメージする。でしょ魚群探知機ないんだったら、じゃあそれやろうかなみたいな。で、じゃあ魚群探知機に他の目的ないかしらと。あります。魚の群れを可視化するだけじゃなくて、海中、海底の様子を可視化するっていうのがありますと。ほうほう、なるほど。じゃあ、海中、海底の様子を可視化するのを魚群探知機じゃなくて他の方法、代替案でやるとしたら、これ、潮目などから頭の中にイメージするっていう方法があるわけですよ。もちろんあるわけです。じゃあ魚の群れを可視化するのはそもそも何の目的ですか、そもそも。って聞くと、そもそも魚の群れを可視化するのは、そうかと。魚の群れを見つけるのが目的だと。当たり前ですよね。当たり前。じゃあ、魚の群れを見つけるのに、魚の群れを可視化するっていう方法はあるけど、他に方法はないかと。あります。勘と経験に頼るってのがあります。でしょ？だって見えないんだもん。はい。で、じゃあ海中の海底の様子を可視化するっていうのはそもそも何の目的かというと、効率的に船を移動するためですよと。方法と。じゃあ効率的に船を移動するのの他の方法ありますかというと、例えば勘と経験に頼る。あまり笑いが起きないけど、みんな真剣？眠い？勘と経験に頼ると。で、効率的に移動するのの他の方法ありませんかというと、外部からの情報を得る。 GPS とか漁協からの無線とか他の船からの情報とか、こういうのもあります。で、じゃあ効率的に移動するのはそもそも何の目的ですかというと、魚の群れを見つけるっていうのが目的ですね。で、魚の群れ、あ、ごめんなさい、効率的に移動するのの他の目的は何かないかなと考えながら、そうすると燃料を節約するっていうのが目的ですと。で、燃料を節約するのの代替案は何かないかと考えると、船を乗り換えるっていうのがありますよ。燃費のいい船乗ればいいじゃんという話がある。で、魚の群れを見つけるののそもそもの目的は何かと聞くと、効率的に収穫することだなと。で、効率的に収穫するの一つの方法は魚の群れを見つければいいんだけど、他の方法なんかないかなと考えると、漁業の仕方をもう変えちゃうとか、 もういっそ養殖しちゃえばいいじゃんと。もう魚取んなくていい、養殖しちゃえと。で、さらに効率的に収穫するのはそもそも何の目的かというと、利益を上げるのが目的だねと。で、燃料を節約するのも利益を上げるのが目的だなと。で、じゃあ利益を上げるのに効率的に収穫したり、それから燃料を節約したりっていう方法もあるけれども、他の方法ないかなと考えると、単価の高い魚取っちゃえばいいんじゃないかと。で、さらに利益を上げるののそもそもの目的は何ですかというと、家族を幸せにしたいなと漁師さんは思ってますよと。じゃあ家族を幸せにするそもそもの目的はみたいな、これもうね、だんだんだんだん全問答です。全問答で、これ見たら分かるように、どんどん抽象度が上がってきます。どんどん抽象度が上がってって、そもそも家族を幸せにするのに魚群探知機があるんだなとかって、そういう言い方ができるわけですよね。だからもはや魚群探知機じゃなくてもいいんじゃねえか論がどんどん出てくるわけですけど、でもこの辺になってくると、また魚群探知機でもこういうオプションが出てくるんだななんていうのが見えてくるわけですよね。で、これそもそも何の目的だっけ議論をするわけですけど、これなんでこれ日本無線さんと作ったのかっていうのをちょっと紹介しておきます。注目したのはこことここなんです。これ日本無線さんのエンジニアとデザイナーと、それから営業課長さんと、まあ営業課長さんがうちの学生さんなんですけど、で彼と一緒にこれを作っていて、注目したのはここです。魚群探知機 のこれ販売促進用のパンフレットの表紙をですね、こう利益の先の目的と製品イメージを結びつけられないかなっていうインサイトだった。つまり普通パンフレットって表紙になんかこうスペックが書いてあったり、なんかちょっと かっこいいっていうか、こうハスに撮った写真が、魚群探知機の写真が載ってて、黒光りしたなんかいわゆるメカメカしいパンフレットなんですけど、魚群探知機のパンフレットって持って帰って漁師さんはお母ちゃんにこれ買ってもいいって聞くらしいんですよ。聞くらしいんですね。だから本当はこの利益が上がる、魚がいっぱい取れますっていうよりも、家族が幸せになりますっぽいイメージがお母さんに伝わった方がいいよって言われるんじゃないかっていう、こういう話になったんですね。なので実は上位の目的にこういうのがあるんだったら、そういうのを表紙の1枚ぐらいそういうテイストにしてはどうかなっていう議論をしました。それからもう一つ、ここですね。効率的に収穫するっていうのが実はまあかなり上位の目的なんだけど、その中の一つに漁業の仕方を変えるなんてのがあると。じゃあ漁業の仕方の提案をするような機能を魚群探知機に持たせれば、今の魚群探知機よりももう少し魅力が増すんじゃないのかなというような、ただ可視化するだけじゃなくて、そういう何かサジェッションみたいなことはできないだろうかなという議論を、これはエンジニアの人たちとしました。こんな風にですね、最初はなんてことない魚群探知機からスタートするんですが、こうやって上位の目的と代替案をこう考えていくと、なんかこう魚群探知機のこのイメージが少しずつ広がっていくの分かりますかね。魚群探知機のライバルが勘と経験だっていうのは、まあこれ直感的に分かりますよね。でも魚群探知機の実はある意味でのライバルは、燃費の船に乗り、燃費のいい船に乗り換えられたら魚群探知機いらねえよっていう人もいるかもしれないなとか、そうだから、これらはライバルともなり得るというわけ、ライバルともなり得るし、逆の言い方すると、この魚群探知機買うとあなたが燃費のいい船に乗り換えたぐらいの効果を得られますよという宣伝をしてもいいわけですよね。うまく宣伝を持っていけばそういうブランディングもできるねと、こんな話をしていましたというのがこれです。So I'll do the English version for this. Okay, well, I'm not going to go step by step, but here, okay. So this is the life log shoes that I don't know, just shoes that has a life log. It's one of the wearable healthcare device that I thought about. So this is my concept, life log shoes, okay? The shoes that takes the life log.And then my purpose is, okay, I was thinking, to keep track of walking exercise. So that's one purpose. And one option of life log, one option would be life log shoes, right? One option. But I can come up with alternative. My smartphone probably can do this, right? Or do manually, right? You can do it manually. You can always do it manually without using any kind of device.And life log shoes, I found out there is more purposes. To present to others that you are a health concerned person. You want to show off that you are a health concerned person. And there's an alternative to that, other healthcare stuff, right? Not only the life log shoes, but these alternatives still works to serve this purpose. Right? You agree? Okay. And there are a third purpose I found out. to present to others that you are early adapter. Do you know early adapter? Yes, you like the new stuff? 新しいもの好き? Yes, you are early adapter and you're a cool person, right? And the other alternative could be other gadget, like iWatch or Apple Watch, right? If you have Apple Watch instead of this, people would see you as an early adapter and cool person. So, okay, continue on. To keep track of walking exercise, I ask myself, what is the higher purpose of this? Could be to sustain health, right? To sustain health. So one option is to keep track of walking exercise. The other option is not keep track and just do it, right? It's you don't keep track of any record, but just you just keep on doing it. So that's an alternative. And keep track of walking exercise, and then higher purpose could be to sustain motivation to continue the healthy lifestyle. An alternative could be self-motivate or get a coach, right? Get a lifestyle coach. And to present to the others that you're a health-concerned person, higher purpose could be to sustain motivation or to have a reputation that you are a cool person. Okay, I'm talking about you guys, single guys, or some married guys maybe too. Right? You want this reputation sometimes, if especially you're in school. And alternative could be improve what you wear. Right? Improve what you wear can improve this reputation. And then, of course, to represent to the others that you are an early adopter connects to this higher purpose as well. So to achieve this higher purpose, these are three options you can take. Or you can do three of them. And here, this is important. To sustain health, you want to live long, probably. That's the ultimate or higher purpose. And instead of to sustain health, no matter how unhealthy you are, you can just go see a good doctor, right? That'll solve your problem. And so to sustain health, to sustain motivation, to continue the healthy lifestyle, to have a reputation that you are a cool person, you want to get a date. Agree? Yes, okay. And if you want to get a date, of course, these three are options. You can always go for plastic surgery. Easy way to go. So this is what you do with the value graph. And then you can get the insight. Like, I don't know, the insight could be getting a date packaging. Like getting a date packaging and branding may be suitable for a certain age group. Maybe this LifeLog shoe may give a better shot if we package them and then brand them so that you will get a better date, kind of. Like, you know, maybe advertise in Jump no Ushiro. Yeah? Okay. I have a few people following. Good. And new question could arise from here. So what can be a differentiation of a shoes type LifeLog device? So, you know, there could be, I noticed that there could be a lot of competitors, not a shoes type, but I don't know, ring type, headband, glasses type. What can be a differentiation of the shoes type? I need to think about that. I noticed that by drawing value graph. So these could be found by drawing that value graph. Okay? Good. So here's what you're doing. So you understood the value graph, right? So let's do just very, very quick practice. Okay? Just very quick. One or two or three just up, okay? Try to draw value graph for Twitter, okay? Twitter service or Twitter concept. Try to create a value graph for Twitter. You can take a look at the example that I showed you, either Japanese or English, I don't care. Try to draw several upper level, okay, here's what you want to do, what I want you to do. Try to come up with several layers of higher purposes and alternatives. And then I want you to try to make it in two colors. You can use post-it notes. You can use post-it notes or a colored pen. So alternative options in blue, maybe. And then your purposes in yellow or the black pen. Okay? So put Twitter at the bottom. Write Twitter at the bottom. Okay? Use post-it note and then the pen as you like. We won't be spending too much time. Just it's a practice. It's a practice. Okay? So start from Twitter and then move up. All right? Ready? Yeah. Group work. All right, go ahead. I'll give you a few minutes to work on this. So you ask yourself, what is the higher purpose? In Japanese, そもそもこれって何の目的だっけ? Okay? Don't forget, そもそも. About the alternatives, okay? Alternatives. And then it's somosomo purpose. Okay, somosomo purpose. It's not the reason, it's the purpose. 理由じゃなくて目的ですからね。理由じゃないですよ。理由と目的違いますからね。目的っぽく書いてください。目的。上位の目的です。魚群探知機の例をちょろちょろ見てくださればわかると思います。I'll give you a blue post-it notes. I'm sorry, I thought you have it already, but I'm gonna pass it out. We're coming to you, so don't worry. Not only identifying the higher purposes, please find out alternatives for that. Think about alternatives. You will find crazy alternatives. You will find surprising alternatives for the Twitters.
だいたいやっぱ。
I want you to try to go up high and then find surprising alternatives. Okay? Interesting alternatives or unknown alternatives, maybe. Okay, who has very, very high level abstraction purpose? Can someone share your high level abstraction purpose? Okay, here, I want you to sit down now. I'll give you more time to do work on a different topic. Tell us about your highest level abstraction level purpose on your chart.
In our team, we got to live better. It's a high level.
To what?
To live
better?
Better, yeah.
Okay, oh, thank you, yes.
Yeah, here you can see. Yo,
ikiru.
To live. Our life or.
Okay.
Live our life.
Their Japanese is so complicated that they cannot even translate into English.
Right.
Okay, all right. Then what was your interesting alternative options? What did you find? Or anywhere, any level. Okay, going karaoke, they found out it kind of serves as a competitor. Or, I don't know, you can call it it's a competitor, or it might be a partner, but that could be alternative option to serve higher purpose that Twitter is serving. Okay, it's a partial competitor, right? Okay, good, thank you. Any other higher purposes? Any interesting one? Self-esteem, okay, all right. How did you climb up the ladder, or how did you climb up the purposes? Can you read it out loud from the Twitter up to help self-esteem? Kenji, there's a microphone. Yes.
Twitter is to share what we are doing or you are doing,
mm-hmm.
and why we share what you're doing is to show off something to others.
Yes.
And then why you want to show off something is to gain self-confidence.
Okay.
And then why we need to have some self-confidence is for self-esteem.
Self-esteem, okay. What did you find out as a Twitter's competitor or alternative options?
Get a degree.
Get a degree, okay. All right, so that'll... Okay, they say getting degree will serve you to gain self-confidence. Instead of tweeting, get a degree.
Plastic
I strongly
well.
Agree. Okay, and plastic surgery might figure out the way to get a self-esteem. Yeah, well, yes, true. Okay. So, thank you. All right. So, you get the feeling? You got the feeling? Yeah? What do you think you need to be careful when you're doing this? when you're creating a value graph, what do you think you need to be careful of? Anything that you noticed? Yes, so Nobi.
Wording is very important.
Ah, why?
Because if we write tell, just tell directory to something to your friend, that just tell.
Mm.
Tell means very different to each other, even in Japanese. Even
yes. Exactly.
So wording is very important.
Right. If you have just a word there, it does not describe what you are talking about. So try to put it in a short phrase. Even in Japanese. It's not really good to have just a word, like 自信. Or you should probably say 自信を得る or 自信を持つ. Okay? Or like not just tell, but to tell your friend what you are doing or whatever like this. So that it's self-explanatory. Self-explanatory. Okay. And what else did you notice? Okay, there's a lot. Okay, Ryo.
Considering the match of the layer.
Mm. Ah, the level of abstraction.
Yeah.
Okay, now it's getting in your mind. Good. Yes, that was my virus that I gave you in the morning. Okay, now you're infected. Yes, because your layers of abstraction can change so dramatically, right? You can go straight up to the ultimate happiness of mankind, right? But that's too far away. So that you want to keep some steps. You can go, it's okay. Or you can hope for the happiness of the universe. I don't care, but yes. But you want to keep up the ladder or the layers. Thank you. Okay. Who had a? Okay. Yeah, Amy.
I think you should just jump out of the box and to consider what the people, the customer, really care about. So I think the advantage of the Twitter is just save money. I think if you just promote the Twitter and one day Docomo SoftBank will disappear. So you can just save our money for free charge. We need 3G and can make a call with our family.
Okay. So what she's saying that she figured out several, competitors, possible competitors, but Twitter has an advantage because it's cheap and you can do it so quickly that it has a strong point. It's a strength, right? Instead of going getting a degree, instead of going karaoke, it's so cheap. It's a better option in a money wise. Okay, good. You can do the comparison with different competitors. Good. Let's just go one more. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Your name is Kazuki. Okay. Yeah. You're Endo. Yeah. Okay. All right. Good.
I think that the most important thing is the thinking about the value graphs of value graph. In other words, the purpose of value graph.
Okay.
Using value graph because the usage of value graph is there are various types of the usage of value graph. So, in case we want to do the ice breaks, we can value graph as a brainstorming and correspond and each mental model by using a value graph.
Yes.
But when we want to decompose the detailed purpose and converge the discussion, we have to use a value graph in a limited scope.
Right, with a little bit more careful.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Careful steps, because you want to keep the misi, right? You want to keep the misiness of your purposes. You don't want overlaps, and you don't want to mess around with the level of abstraction. You want to keep it nice and neat, so that it's easy to understand, easy to follow, true. So, as Kazuki said, you can do it like a brainstorm format, but it doesn't make much sense to you, probably. You want to become a little bit careful about what you're talking about and how you describe it, like Nobi said, how you describe it and how you layer them, okay? So I think you have now a good sense of what the value graph is. All right, that was a practice. So let's do this. Okay. Somebody in your team has some idea from Monday, right? Hopefully. Can any of you recall one or two or three ideas that you had on Monday? You talked about healthcare solutions or healthcare stuff. You took photos, right? Choose one idea out of that, or one concept, or one insight out of that, all right? And then discuss and create a value graph, upper half. this time a little bit with a little bit of care, okay? And if you don't have one, then you can do wearable life log device. If you don't have anything to do it, then you can do this for exercise, all right? And here's the thing you need to think about. Whose purpose are you talking about? Because you've been talking about Twitter user purposes, right? You can do this for Twitter company purpose. But now you were doing for user. So you can, maybe this is my practice. You want to separate, you know, when you do the user version, then keep it as a user. If you want to do the company version, then keep it as a company. And you can set it aside and later on you can compare. But if you want to keep it, you want to keep it simple, or you want to keep it whose purpose, whose shoes are you in, or whose viewpoint are you at, all right? So, and you want to search for alternative purposes. Your purpose, you guys are doing great because you're not just focusing on one purpose. Sometimes when you do this, or sometimes you talk with the company truly believe that their product has just one purpose. But often, no. It has several purposes. There are primary purpose, secondary purposes. However, there are usually several purposes that will combine together for one service or one product. So you want to search for some different purposes. And of course, you want to search for alternative options, and especially with the higher level purposes. Why? Why do you want to go for higher level purpose alternative options? Because you get more freedom. Because, for example, if you look at, so the very near, the alternatives near at the bottom, it's Facebook or some other SNS, right? But if you go up some ladder or levels, then you see, get a degree, plastic surgery. Who has 出家? No? No one has? For self-esteem or maybe to live better, you just forget about everything and become a monk, right? That's a solution. So if you go up higher and then find alternative, you find interesting ones. So try that too. And you want to go for more abstract purposes. So you are structuralizing and visualizing your purposes and alternative options to expand the solution space. Agree? All right. So let's take out whatever the photograph you took from the Monday and then choose one of the ideas. I know you're in the different teams, so just choose one idea and try to create a value graph on that. Okay, just do small discussion and then try to create. Don't argue too much which idea you want to draw a diagraph on, because that's not the whole point. And if you have no clue which idea to do, just do wearable life log device. Okay, that's your concept. I'll give it to you. All right, I'll give you about, 30 minutes to do so. All right, let's go then.
Thank you.
So you get higher level abstraction purposes as you move upward.
弁当だけど矢印書いてるんだけど、あのね、視覚、人間のほとんど視覚情報でいいんだけど、でね、矢印を書いてるんだ。脳みそにそういう刺激をあげた方がいいです。
Thank you.
design,
like, okay, you add new purpose, right? You can add new purpose to whatever the device or whatever you're thinking about. So, and, interesting competition or collaboration. So your alternative could be competitors. At the same time, it could be collaborator. You understand that? Yes. And chance to redefine your concept. How can you redefine your concept, the things that you have in the bottom? How can you redefine this using the value graph or any discussion based on the value graph? So look for insight that helps you to refine or update or redefine your concept or idea. That's something you have at the bottom. Understood? All right, so that's added. So choose your insight post-it notes. If you need a color, I can provide you with it, probably. Do we have another color post-it note? Or should we go and get it? Can you give them a look?
ガラッと言い方が明るめもよくなるけど、少し人の方が好きだと思います。 今の。これって一人の、みんなで。
Sit down. And this time, I'm asking you different questions, so you need to answer differently, okay? I won't ask you what you found in the value graph, but what did you find out so that you can reflect on your concept or idea? I want to ask you for the outcome, okay? Here's two words I want to use differently. Output and outcome, okay? Output is what you draw, okay? But I'm interested in your outcome. This is something that might not in your drawings, but this is something that you gain from what you've done, all right? So whenever I say output, it's the paper that you have just drawn. When I say outcome, that's something you gained by doing it, all right? So now I'm interested in your outcome. How did you update your concept or idea? Something you did not know that you found out doing the value graph. Any team? Okay, Kazuki, or your team. Yeah, please hold it up, but talk about the outcome.
Okay, so our idea is rental okan.
Ah, competitor. Oh, okay. They were working on the rental okan as well. Okay.
Rental mom.
Rental mom. Yes. Rental mom and rental okan sounds very different. I like rental mom better.
Okay, so the output.
Okay,
is the one is the available purposes and many alternatives we can generate it. So it is the output. Mm. The outcome we got mainly three insights.
Okay.
Yeah, our competitor is not a welfare company. Mm. Our competitor is an entertainment company.
Oh, okay.
So the initial concept is a welfare service.
Right. It sounded like a welfare service. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But our alternatives is a So that to accomplish a purpose of making enjoying, providing a joyful daily life, the alternative is so. Example is go to Tokyo Disneyland.
Okay.
Or getting a girlfriend.
Okay. They so have an opposition probably.
Yes. So that maybe the rental girlfriend is our alternatives, and maybe
Really? Maybe okay.
It is a competitor of our service.
Interesting.
So the secondly is the our service approaches the mental health, not a physical health. There are two types of health.
Yes.
So mental health and the physical health. It is our definition of health.
Okay.
So the our service approaches the mental health. And the third point is financial. And is a mom viewpoint. So initial concept focuses on how we provide the service with users, and
which is the young boys, right? Or young research student or something like that, right?
Well,
it was okay. Yes.
Only focus on the quality of service and the users.
Yes.
But it is also very important to have a viewpoints of the workers, mom.
Ah, okay.
Viewpoints of Okan.
Oh yes.
So it is they are our insight and they are our outcome.
All right. Did you understand? Did you all understand? Good. All right. Thank you. Oh, anything to add? Anything to add?
I felt interesting because we start from rental mom and the one of the rental moms. One purpose of the rental mom is create new job for mothers.
Yes.
And
yes.
The one is to give working opportunity and increase number of worker, and it helps improve Japanese financial situation.
Yes.
So if this rental mom's concept was improving Japanese financial solution, we can provide to live shorter consultant or something. If you live shorter, it will help Japanese financial solution. So that is not good. I don't say it's good or not, but it must be a very insight for me.
Yes. So yes, I agree. So like I said, so some your idea has different purposes, very different purposes. They talk about users' viewpoint, but like Kazuki said, they found a workers' viewpoint is also very very useful or very important, right? This is multi-sided platform. You need users and then you need workers to register for this program. It's one of the common business model, just like Gurunabi or just like any other these services, right? It's multi-sided platform. This is a model of the business model, right? So you need to, this is very, very important because if you have just two mom registered and 550 students who want the rental mom, it's not gonna work. Right, it's not going to work. So you need both sides. Okay, good. Thank you. All right, let's hear from one other team. Okay, another rental mom. The competitor. You decide which one you like.
What we discussed is about rental mom as well. And then when we are talking about it, like we found out that maybe everybody knows it, but mom do everything, right? Mom can do everything for us. And then we found that we need to, maybe we need to focus on some part, like since the service concept, we are deciding service concept, and then the concept is a bit ambiguous. We say service, rental mom and so on. And then we found three directions to take, we might be able to take. And one direction would be kind of to get disciplined.
by this rental mom?
Yeah, by this rental mom. Since, as you know, when we grow up, we have no chance to be disciplined. If nobody tells how you should live and so on, there might be some news for that as well. In order to be a good person. Somebody want to have some like discipline, right? Maybe it is not clear needs, but there might have some needs in your kind of deeper point. And the second point is they have freedom or sense of security. Yeah, the second part is to feel the sense of security. Actually, the alternatives could be a gun, to buy a gun or something like that, because we want to be saved or we want to be protected by somebody. And so we found that probably we might be able to find some like strong mom or like big mom or something like that to create the service as well. And the last part would be to ask for advice. When we got when we got some problem, we need somebody to like talk with, to consult us. So the concept is like that. Maybe we need to take the direction of not a mom, it's more like grandmom or something like that. Since they have a lot of like life and like they have a lot of experience in their life. So that is our direction. But actually I got surprised that you got the younger one. Rental girlfriend.
Yes. We
got the different dimensions. Yeah. Right. Yeah, that was interesting for us.
I'd like to emphasize that deep teaching me is how to buy money. This is a strong. This is going to be a strong point for this service. Because we cannot buy such service by money usually. So, good concept.
Okay, all right.
Yes, so it's really interesting. They started out from the same box, right, at the bottom. But during the discussion, they found out some different insight. And then they found that, okay, so rental mom sounded stupid, right? But it still does. However, after several discussions, there are some insight of businesses, right? There are some insight for businesses, the real businesses. So it's not about a idea or an idea, but it's about the insight that we get from that. So Rentalbaum gave this team about maybe it's not really a mom, but we're kind of hoping for somebody like a grandma type to maybe get consulted. But grandma does not try to solve your problem. She listens, and says two words, right? So that's probably what we want,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So this is it's a really good, could be a really good, strong business concept to actually, you know, make it happen. So it's really interesting to see how these two groups are different, even though they started out from the same idea. But by talking, what would be the higher purpose, you will actually refining your concept, right? Don't you think this is kind of counterintuitive? Because when you want to, you know, refine your concept, you're kind of going down, right? You kind of have a feeling that you need to be concrete. But instead, you have to have a higher purpose figured out to do what to do, to know what to do. So it might be counterintuitive, but it's really, really important. And then one thing I can tell you is that if you do value graph in the very early stage of project, then your project will work better. Because now this team knows that you're not going for rental girlfriend. Instead, you have a three, well, still ambiguous, but three direct directions that you want to follow, right? Kind of. So even though they separate and do different individual tasks, they still share this image where they're heading to. Okay? Without this, if they just follow the term rental mom and do research and then they do some interview, probably they will come back with very, very different materials. Do you understand this? Yes. So thank you, you can sit down. Doing value graph in an early stage and then reflecting or looking back during the project is super important. Because you want to see how your mindset has changed, how your goal setting has changed, what new competitors or what new alternative you have found. So it's like it's a living document, we can say this. So you create value graph early stage in the project, and you start from there, but you keep updating. You keep updating and see how it evolved, how it converged, or how it alternated. All right? Good. All right, let's take a break. And during the break, since we have too many people in one group, we will move you around. Do you have that ready?
Maybe starting from 3:15. Oh.
What?
3:15.
3:15? What do you mean?
Sorry.
Yeah, I will have a... I'll just have a break until 3, and can you get ready by then?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So let's take a break until a little past 3. Please be back at a little past 3, and then we will shuffle you because we have too many people on one table, and we have one table left. So I will show you who to go where. All right? Let's take a break.